lessons that are good to learn as soon as possible. In my politically incorrect opinion, inspired by lessons that I think the video was called Lessons That Are Learned Too Late in Life, and I think, no, if you're alive, you can still apply them. But on this video, it sort of was saying that once you're older, you can't learn or apply new things. I'm thinking, no. If anything, it probably should have been titled Things to Have Learned Earlier in Life to Have Less Regret, to Be More Effective. Something like that. But when I saw that video, I thought, you know, it's a good subject, poor wording. On my artistic journey of capitalism, man, it's comical, pathetic, and disappointing. Some of the headaches I've had that are, you would think that one wouldn't experience in this millennium in America, from people that supposedly pretend to care or say that they care, and even more disappointing is from people who label themselves family or friends. And with TV propaganda from television, mainstream media, celebrities, Hollywood, Disney movies, and other shit, I think the sort of belief is taboo. But it's annoying to, I should make that all black. That's more black. I think one of the points was by playing it safe. And there's other things in life, but I think that's overall the one that scares me the most, because I think it was Jermon who said, the more success, more doors of success open to the people who knock, something like that. The more doors you knock, the more likely you're open doors of success. And I thought, what the fuck? It's true. And again, if I would have gone the route of what I grew up with, what I grew up around with, who I was raised by, who were my supposed teachers, who were my supposed guardians or adults or the professionals, I thought these workers today, all the older dudes, MTA on their cars, it said supervisors, and they're just fucking around on their on their smartphones. I'm thinking, fuck, man, that's life. I'm joining the union, getting paid to fuck around, and now you're the adult. You reached your final form. I'm thinking, no, I don't think that should be it. Should be it at all. And I get a lot of blowback for having this opinion. What do you mean, man? Well, why don't you start your own business? Well, why aren't you world famous yet? Coming from somebody who didn't even try to fail. Wait, that don't make no damn sense. You know, I could accept the words and sympathize even with people who have tried and failed and be like, well, fuck, man. Maybe he thought, fuck, man, is it Icarus? Who flew too close, so close to the sun that his wings melted. But maybe this person got so high or so emotional or deeply involved with the life design that when it came crashing down, it was like Icarus falling from the sky. It could simply just be a mental devastating impact. I think what else was taught there that was a regret in life. So I'm seeing another video with from another channel that was similar in title. Was it like, so you're going to die? Confessions of a deathbed or some shit. I forgot what the fuck. But regretting the things. regretting the things that weren't tried, more than the things that you failed at. Some water. I had a friend of mine who taught me about travel, how to travel, what is traveling. I'm not sure if you got stopped in Colombia or Argentina. But anyways, the customs told him to go report to the U.S. Embassy because there were no more pages for his passport to be stamped on. I thought, fuck, I didn't know that. Customs had to have a something to stamp on. I was like, what the fuck? They do? Is it a must? Can't stamp over something. Didn't know that. Chicken, what else it needs green? I think at times I can understand how people could say, man, you're stuck up, you don't talk to people. Because I think of this one fucking cuck who bags my groceries, a big fucking big ass weenie. yeah, man, this Dodger games, man, this is what you do, man. You go to the AM, PM, to the gas station, you know, you buy your beer and your hot dog. And then, man, stay in the park and you eat and drink all your stuff because, you know, they charge you too much in the stadium. And I'm thinking, dude, you're paying so much for food for a ghetto ass, that shit's fucking hood. And to go watch a bunch of dudes that I remember when those bastards went on strike. We're not getting paid enough to play baseball, to throw a ball around. And that was, remember at that time, the Dodgers were, I think they were contender. They were doing real good. Looked like they could be heading out to the World Series contender. And, I thought, what the fuck? Imagine if I got paid $1 million a year for this YouTube channel. Just to draw. And July? We're in July, right? I say, alright, well look, I need to make 100 videos this year to fulfill my contract. And I will do that, but I'm on video 99 already done, so this is video 100. So right now, just to let you know, guys, I'm gonna stop doing this because $1 million isn't enough. I understand you guys are all warehouse workers, day laborers, struggling art students, and my stuff helps you. But you know what, man? I got a yacht, I got a Corvette, I got Sea-Doos, I want to buy a ranch, I want to, what else would I want to do that I don't need to? I got to have a jacuzzi, I need liposuction, I need all these things, and if I don't get paid more, well then, you know, I can't be here, it's not fair. Okay, and I would think that the logical people would say, you know what, this motherfucker's complaining about just sitting there and drawing. I need to make another video called "Maybe He Ain't Scooping What He's Pooping." I read that as a comment on a Joe Rogan video. Joe isn't scooping what he's pooping. Lost my train of thought there. Because I keep to myself because I feel like the only way that this is going to get done is if I put in the time, man. Put in the time. I've thought about it. How can I not apply a pencil to paper and still get this done? And me get the credit. And I haven't figured out a way to for that to be possible. So I've got to keep at it here. And I bring this up because also I think of this one kid who I think he already graduated high school, but he had his he wanted to follow his heart. And oh man, it just sucks to see those that are called family and friends say no, fuck your heart, fuck following your passion. You need to buy a house and start a family as soon as possible. And I'm busy enough with this and other things in life. And I think simply by mentioning the pain of regret, if people could marinate on that, even if you're already flipping burgers, or if you're going to have a shotgun wedding right after high school, right after prom, just to keep this in the back of your mind, to fulfill potential. And also, I think we take a lot of lessons from people that call themselves teacher, but I don't think we ever, I know I didn't, think, wait a minute, that's teacher, but what does teacher mean, and what's the purpose of this teaching, and is what this person is teaching, do they know it? I've seen obese doctors. I don't mean fat, I mean obese. And I think, how is this person, speaking about health? Telling people what is a good choice or the best choice, the smart choice, when they themselves knowingly are not just poisoning the body, but diving right into it. You have some fucking wimps and say, well, maybe the, what's it called, the, maybe she has a thyroid problem, or her metabolism has slowed down with age. Okay. And now we're going to the excuses. Oh, well, you know what? Maybe this, maybe that. After it, motherfuckers.